He started singing when he was just 9 years old, and over the years, he perfected his craft. Now he is one of the distinguished opera singers in the country. Joining us tonight is opera singer Andrew Fernando. Welcome to the show, Andrew.
Thank you very much.
So tell me, you started singing at nine. What were you singing?
Well, I was singing an opera, a role in an opera, actually, as a boy soprano.
Okay.
And that was when my voice was still very, very high. It dropped through the years.
Okay.
But it was an opera production presented by our church when I was 9 years old. And my mom told me to audition for this role. I didn't know what I was up for.
Yeah.
So I went to the audition and sang, and they cast me for the role.
That's
of
amazing.
Amal in an opera called Amal and the Night Visitors.
Oh my gosh, so you were the lead.
I was the lead,
there
yeah.
At nine
At
years
nine.
Old.
I was quite a ham.
Well, I suppose you have to be in a way, right? To
yeah,
sing opera.
Yeah, it's part of the game.
Were you? What would you do? Would you just sing around the house before that?
Well, I love singing and I love dancing too when I was a kid. And then so my mom thought it would be a great opportunity for me to audition. So my mom brought me to that audition.
Okay. And so that was kind of the start of your opera career. So what happened next? I mean, did you decide to study music somewhere? Did you
in
study
college,
here?
Yes.
Okay.
In college, I went to the University of Santo Tomas Conservatory of Music, where I pursued a degree in music, and I majored in vocal performance. And so, but in between the years of me singing as a boy soprano and as a baritone, of course, my voice was dropping, so you know, I had to go through puberty and all that. So, but in between those, my voice type as being a soprano and a baritone, I was singing in my high school choir. And I would sing solos here and there. But at that time, my voice was really dropping. And then when I became a baritone, that's when I decided to take it up in college as a degree.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
And then after that, I mean, I understand now you work all over the world. How did this happen?
Well, after UST and after starting my career here in Manila, I went to the Hong Kong Academy for the Performing Arts.
Yes.
And so I took my postgraduate studies there. And so I was an opera major when I was there, and I would sing locally in Hong Kong.
And who would you sing for? Tell me.
Sorry,
who would you sing for? Did you sing for anyone that, like, our audience might know?
Oh, well, back then I was a regular guest of the former governor, Chris Patten.
Yes.
And so I would be singing at the house there. And then I sang for the Hong Kong Arts Festival and the Hong Kong Urban Council at the Cultural Center in Hong Kong.
Yes.
And then so in 1998, I sang with the Los Angeles Opera. It was an outreach performance, part of the festival in Hong Kong. We did a production of Zalome. And it was those people who were part of that production who encouraged me to try my luck in the States, which I did in 1998. So I went to the States and auditioned for a few companies there. And I landed a position as resident artist of Opera Pacific in Orange County, California. And then everything started from there.
That's amazing. Yeah. And how many countries have you performed in, and how many companies have you worked with?
Well, I couldn't count the countries.
Okay, yes,
and
that
the
many.
Companies, but as far as production, the Noli Metangere opera I'm doing right now could be my over 100 opera productions I've done.
Goodness.
In my life.
Tell me a little bit about the Noli Metangere opera going on right now. That's a Philippine production.
It's a Philippine production. The Noli Metangere right now at Resorts World. Well, we started with the performances in New York last year, October of last year, in fact, almost a year ago. And then it went to Washington, D.C. I wasn't part of that cast because I started rehearsing here in Manila. And now it's in Manila. And so we had huge success in New York and in Washington, D.C., and now we're bringing it here to Manila.
It's a high-value production. I saw it.
It is. Oh, yeah. You saw it. Yes, it is. It's a very well-thought-of production, very prepared. We have an amazing cast, and we have an amazing production staff working for Noli, and so...
It's quite an international cast?
It is. Well, it's an all-Filipino cast, but some of us are singing internationally.
Yes.
Arcisa, for example, Antonio Mendezona, actually is half Filipino and half Spanish.
Okay.
And she's doing Sisa in our production, and she's based out in New York.
Okay. I have to ask you, since you've performed in so many different countries, what are the challenges that you've come upon? You know, as a Filipino, working in all these different markets, was it difficult to go international, to go global?
Well, in my field, in the opera field, it's tough for anyone, no matter which country you come from. And because it's staying on the top of your game is the biggest challenge for me. There are a lot of wonderful opera singers. There are a lot of talented singers. Mm-hmm. And so that's the biggest challenge for me, to be always on my game. And to, when I audition, that I'm top shape and all that, that I have something unique to present, so I get the role, or get hired, or get noticed. And as a Filipino, you know, we don't have many operas here happening in the Philippines, especially in the recent years. But we have an amazing training program here in the Philippines.
Okay.
We have wonderful conservatories here. Mm-hmm. And so I feel that as a Filipino, I am prepared for the challenges.
That's good. Yeah. Are there any tips you have for other Filipinos who would like to follow in your footsteps?
Well, all I can say is that you just have to go for it. Mm-hmm. And you have this dream, and no, you shouldn't listen to anyone who would tell you that you don't have it to make it, right? You don't have what it takes to make it. You just have to go for it. You just have to be brave and really find your place in this industry.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much,
Andrew.
Yeah. So impressive.
Thank you very much.
Anyway, when we come back, we'll talk to an entrepreneur who expanded their business overseas. That's next after this break, so stick around.
To dream the impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable foe, to bear with unbearable sorrow, to run where the brave dare not go, to right the unrightable wrong, to love during chased from afar, to try when your arms are too weary, to reach the unreachable star. This is my quest, to follow that star. No matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right without question or pause, to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know if I'll only be true to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm.